friends. Children, in my previous lecture, I have explained that how there was an outbreak of revolution in France. As a result, the king understood that he cannot be in power for long, so he diverted and agreed for constitutional monarchy. Now the question arises, what is constitutional monarchy? Well, a constitutional monarchy is a system where the king is there only for namesake, but the real power lies in the hands of the constitution. The ruler, the king, will now be able to rule only on his own, not rather his powers will be limited. For example, in present time Britain has monarchy, but they have to follow what the parliament says. The National Assembly completed the draft of constitution in 1791, and its main objective was to limit the powers of the monarch. The powers were assigned to different institutions like the legislature, executive and the judiciary. When we are talking about the limitations of the powers of the monarch, we find it was joined by many people like the nobles out of fear. Finally, it was successful in removing the privileges which the church and the nobles enjoyed. The Constitution of 1791 gave the power to make laws in the National Assembly, which was indirectly elected. Here, what we find is that all the different powers which were now separated and assigned to different institutions like the legislature, executive and judiciary, all three organs made France a constitutional monarchy. Thirdly, all the active citizens who were only men. Children, please listen carefully. I told you men only. Women were not allowed at this particular point of time. All the active citizens of men who were above 25 years of age and who had paid taxes equal to that of at least 3 days of labor wages were allowed to cast their vote. The remaining men and women do not have right to vote. They were not allowed to cast the vote as in every democratic country like India. We are all, irrespective of caste, creed, age, sex, have all the rights so that we can choose our representative. Lastly, we find that the constitution began with the right of the declaration of the rights of men and citizens. This was a document that guaranteed that every citizen of a French man was equal. People, especially the French people, embraced the document while the kings and the nobles did not. Various rights such as right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, equality before laws were established as natural and inalienable rights. This means they belong to each human being by birth. It means that the place in which they were born, they have natural rights which could not be taken away. Now, it was the legal duty of the state to protect citizens' natural right. Children, in your book, you will see that there are various political symbols. These political symbols were used by the illiterate people in the 18th century. Now, what were these symbols signified? The broken chain stands for the act of becoming free. The bundle of rods and fetters shows the strength lies in unity. The eye between a triangle radiating light. This means that all seeing eyes stands for knowledge. The scepter, it means the symbol of royal power. Snake biting, its tail to form a ring, it was a symbol of eternity. Red cap, cap worn by a slave upon becoming free. Blue, white and red was the colors of France. The winged women was the personification of law. Personification means it is a symbol which signifies that now the France is free from the monarchy rule and they have established their own constitutional monarchy. Lastly, the law tablet was there, the law which was same for all and equal before it. Moving ahead, France abolishes monarchy and becomes republic. The question here is, what is a republic? A republic is a form of a government in which the country is considered as a public matter, not the private concern or the property of the rulers. Louis XVI had signed the constitution, but also he entered into a secret negotiation with the king of Persia. Rulers of neighboring countries were worried about the development of France and made plans to put down their events. The National Assembly voted to declare war against Persia and Austria. Thirdly, the patriotic song Marcellus, composed by the poet Roger de Sully, as sung for the first time by volunteers as they march into Paris, which is a national anthem of France. Fourth, the revolution wars brought losses and difficulties to the people. The Constitution of 1791 gave political rights not only to the rich people of the society. Political clubs became important from rallying point of view, in which most successful club was that of Jacobins.